Hi everyone, welcome to this module on Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Fast Connect service. My name is Rohit Rahi and I'm part of the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure team. So Fast Connect, what is this service called Fast Connect? Fast Connect provides a dedicated and private connection with higher bandwidth options and a more reliable and consistent networking experience when compared to internet-based connections. So the idea here is you can connect to OCI directly or via pre-integrated network partners. Think about this as having your own high occupancy vehicle lane in the internet. So your traffic doesn't go through the normal internet, which can be unreliable because internet is a collection of networks which are all paired together. So the connectivity might be unreliable. You might get very inconsistent network performance. In contrast, Fast Connect gives you that dedicated and private connectivity, sort of having your own high occupancy vehicle lane within the internet. You get port speeds of 1 Gbps and 10 Gbps increments. So some providers support only 1 and 10, and some providers would support 1, 2, 3, etc., etc. And you can even go higher than 10 Gbps. There are two different ways you can use Fast Connect. One is called private peering, where you extend your on-premises data centers into Oracle by using private connectivity, and you access services running in a virtual cloud network. Or the other model is called public peering, where you can connect to your on-prem environment to some of the OCI public services such as object storage, and we'll look into these in more detail in subsequent slides. There is no charge for inbound outbound data transfer. And as you can imagine, Fast Connect uses BGP protocol. So what are the two scenarios where you would use Fast Connect? The first scenario is when you are co-locating with Oracle in a Fast Connect location, right? So your existing network is here, right? You are co-located with Oracle and you just connect the edges together with BGP, right? It's a BGP peering you do here. The second scenario is when you connect with Oracle through an Oracle provider. So this can be Megaport or this can be AT&T or someone, right? And you have your own connectivity from your existing network to the provider. And then through the provider, you connect to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure here, right? And again, you could use layer 2 here or layer 3 connectivity, depending on what your provider supports. So you could either do that, but you could basically you are connecting to a network provider already, and you already might have set up that connection, and then you connect from that provider through Oracle Cloud Infrastructure, and using this sort of a two hop connection, you are connected you're connecting your on-prem environments to the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure. So there is this concept called virtual circuit. Virtual circuit is nothing but an isolated network path that runs over one or more physical network connections to provide this single logical connection between customer's edge router and the DRG in OCI. So we talked about this here, right? So you create a virtual circuit and it runs over these might be physical connectivity here, and it provides this connection from your on-premises to the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure DRG. Each virtual circuit is made up of information shared between customer, Oracle, and a provider, as you can recall from the previous picture, right? Make sense? It's possible to have multiple virtual circuits to isolate traffic from different parts of organization, right? So you can have a virtual circuit for this CIDR. You could have another for this CIDR, right? So you could have multiple virtual circuits for different reaching different parts of your organization, or you could just do multiple virtual circuits just for redundancy purposes. And like we said, you know, Fast Connect uses BGP, and then I think I might have a bullet point here which is missing. It might use layer 2 or layer 3 connectivity. So what are these scenarios? We talked about private peering and public peering. So private peering, as we talked about, you're extending your on-prem network to the OCI virtual cloud network, right? So virtual cloud network, you are running let's say your compute or your databases in a private network, and you are extending your on-prem network to reach that to reach your OCI virtual cloud network. The communication happens using private IP addresses, right? So the whole idea here is emphasis on private. You are basically reaching your resources running in VCN through on-premises using private connectivity. Public peering, on the other hand, uses public OCI services such as object storage, right, or console or APIs. And these can be dedicated, these can be reached over dedicated fast connect connection. Why would you do that versus just reaching them publicly over a public internet connection? Well, for the same reason why you would use fast connect, right? It gives you that consistent dedicated connectivity, so you get a much better experience. As you can imagine, in public peering, you don't go through DRG, right? Because again, you're just accessing the public services. DRG is when you have to go through your connectivity for your VCN, right? Remember DRG is one of the gateways for your on-prem. This is the gateway for your on-prem environment. The other gateways we have are things like internet gateway, NAT gateway, service gateway, etc., right? Which have different use cases, whether you are reaching internet or you are reaching Oracle public cloud services from a VCN, you would use a service gateway, etc. So as you can see here in the picture, this is your on-prem environment. This is the fast connect location. And right here, if you're trying to reach your on-premises environment through the fast connect location to a VCN, you would use a DRG, and then this you would reach your VCN here, right? And you could be running compute instances here. You could be running database instances, and all these connectivity would be private. You are going through the private IP addresses. In contrast, if you want to reach object storage, you could still do the same. You could go from your on-prem, but now you are just bypassing the whole DRG and VCN, and you're directly going to your public OCI public services, such as object storage, right? So these are the two models which are supported, and this also comes up in exams. The question might be, you know, if I'm using public peering, which statement is not true? And you know, they will give you four options, and you have to make sure that in public peering, DRG is not used, right? So just be aware of that. DRG is used only in case of private peering. All right, and here is a list of all the fast connect providers, and there's a long list of providers. You should check the online documentation to see, we are adding providers pretty frequently. So you should take a look at the different regions you are planning to use fast connect location, and you know which providers are supported in that particular region. All right, so let's quickly jump over to the console and show a quick demo. Now for the demo, one thing which I want to call out is, in the demo, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the connectivity. Sorry, let me just get the slide back here. In the demo, I'm going to show you the connectivity from here to, from a provider network to OCI. This connectivity from your existing on-premises environment to the provider edge, I'm assuming that you already have this running.